Welcome to University of Chimera Stadium in steamy Tombstone, Arizona, where the only thing hotter than the heat is the ceaseless sinning. The players are ready to rock the red zone and red light district tonight. Let's go down to the field for kickoff. It's the Mayhem Bowl, and today's matchup features the two best teams in the league. The Los Angeles Volts take on the Terror Bay Mutineers. Everyone, Grim Blitzer on deck for tonight's presentation of the Mayhem Bowl. We are going down to the sidelines now to listen in on the pregame speech.
Seriously, man, you think you can go toe-to-toe with me? You get my grill, I'll ruin your world. Ruin it.
And welcome to the NFL Mayhem Bowl. Grim Blitzrow with you here along with Brickhead Mulligan and Briggs Jr.
Hi, everyone. I can't wait for the commercials to start. That's always my favorite part.
We've got the biggest game of the year here, Briggs. Two teams battling each other in the ultimate battle of death.
Yeah, but those butt wiper beer commercials with the horses, they make me want to cry, Grim.
And the kicker just bit the dust on that play. Someone will have to come off the bench to replace him. The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Now, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
Well, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one.
Sure who he was throwing to on that play. Second down and 10.
Hit.
And the crowd loves it. First down and six. He picks up five on that play. And that'll bring up second and one. Second down and five. When the defense calls Thunderclap, the offense is toast.
Why did he ever get zapped? Reminds me, give me an example so I'll watch out where the Huskies go. Don't tweet that yellow snow. When I was a kid, I always hit the yellow snow. They were like lemon snow cones. What the fudge ice cream sandwiches? They didn't taste so good.
Chains moving. That was beautiful.
And it's first and ten. Supercharged and can electrocute any. If you don't hear it coming, it'll knock you right on your ass. Oh, and he fumbles the ball on that hit. When you hurdle and get hit, chances for a fumble increase.
It's a touchdown!
Nobody can touch you with eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey.
Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. first and 10. Second time out, hoping for a miracle.
I witnessed a miracle once. A player was brought back from the dead.
That's not a miracle, partner. That's just how the NFL works. And he booted a high arcing rainbow. And he's got a chance for a good return here.
Several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
And it's first and 10. Set up the offense. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. The offense is down to their last two linemen. Once they're gone, it's game over.
Yeah, who cares? Linemen suck. They don't even deliver any fantasy points.
And it's first and 10. And they've had enough. The offense jumps on side. Nice gain of about 7 yards on that run. stop the clock with her first time out to try and stay in this game.
Oh, nice coaching move here. Hall of Fame caliber.
Well, I mean, it's a pretty standard coaching move at this point in the game.
I won't listen to this blasphemy.
Man, what a hit that was. They stop the clock, but they only have one timeout left. That's nice, Bricks. But our timeouts are for our sponsors, and we need money more than they do. Catch the ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes. And that's the end of the second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the halftime show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered Frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. Cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's gonna have the IQ cue of a rutabaga after that hit. Third down and, well, good luck.
One, hot two. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
Second down and five. He dropped it. If he does that again, they'll drop him. Third down and five.
Not one, not two.
Defense holds him to a 4-yard pickup there. They're going for it on fourth down.
One, hot two.
Oh, and the offense comes up empty. The defense didn't give an inch. If you don't kill this ref with the attack ref dirty trick, you're going to lose, pal.
You kind of deserve it if you're this damn scrim.
And it's first and ten. Defense had enough with this rep and jumps off sides to kill him. First down and one.
One, not two.
Second down and two.
Hot one, hot two.
third down and nine.
Is the game over yet? I gotta go to the vet to have him reattach my big toe to where my thumb was again. It just fell off for the third time today. I was barely even chewing on it.
Hot one, hot two.
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
And that brings us to the end of the third quarter. They'll need to fire on all cylinders to make a comeback in the final quarter. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
Right now. And it's first and ten. And he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a pick ahead. Get the ball, asshole.
Second down and ten. Didn't give an inch. No gain on that play. Third down and 10. For 5 yards.
Hey, didn't move the change of score, did it? How good can it be?
Second down and 5. And that's how you run the football. First down. First and 10. Now, it looks like he wanted to run before he caught it. You gotta keep your eye on the ball.
Come on, you dirtbag. You gotta make that catch.
Second down and 10. Try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
Straight through the uprights. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked out? What do you do then?
Run.
Second there. chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. And it's first and 10. Should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What? And get the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sinners then.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just guineas.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team had a chance to respond.
Calls
on minutes remaining in the game. We'll be right back, folks.
Jeez, can this game take any longer? I got a date with Hot Wanda after this.
Junior, I told you that girl's nothing but trouble. And I don't think that's a mole wanna lick either. Sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him.
And he takes a timeout here. They had two left. I wonder if he has a plan.
Well, maybe he's just going to take the teeth out of the back of his neck that have been stuck there since the opening play.
One, two. Nicely done. Picks up three on that pass play.
Ooh la la.
Second down and seven. They've got one more timeout left, but they've stopped the clock.
Coincidentally happens to be Brett's match stitching time.
That's why the girls call me Speedy Gonzalez.
Caught for the first down. And it's first and ten. That's the last time out. They can't stop the clock anymore.
Can any of us really stop the clock, Rin? I mean, when it comes right down to it, are we not all united by the constant reminder of our own mortality? Of death's constant relentless advance? If only it was...
This guy's gonna get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. And the hurry-up offense wears out the defense since they can't rest their players. And he put in the afterburners after that catch and score. Nicely done! And they line up for the extra point. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The kicker's gonna have to kick the ball just right so his team can recover it. Just starting to pick up some speed.
Hey, Grim, I know a guy if that's what you're after.
And it's first and ten. And those way dirty trick is always good for an easy kill. Second down and ten.
You miss 2 foot putts all the time, Grim.
Straight through the uprights. They need a good return here to set up the offense. They're going to be able to return this one. Shifts gears and goes into his hurry-up offense.
Hot two.
Oh, a great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. Hopefully this game's been over for a long time. The scoreboard and ratings show it. Hell, I started texting around the time the visiting team went into double digits.
Yeah, me too, Grim. Someone sent me a picture of a really weird sausage, though. It was still attached to them.
See that move, baby? I'm the greatest. No, you didn't see it.
Once again, the folks at EvoSan thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation of the Mayhem Bowl. Until next season, this is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off. And that's a wrap. All right, that's another season, boys. Good job. Hey, Bricks, the cheerleader's in, huh? Hey, Junior, start rolling.
On it, boss.
I love you guys. We got the best gig in the world.
Hey, stow it, dipshit. Start filling the hot tub. Hey, where's the champagne?
Today's game was brought to you by ComCrack Entertainment. They're not happy until you're not happy.